Yes students, welcome back. Today in this session we are going to start chapter 3 from our English LIT, and the name of the chapter is The Language of Flowers. I hope and believe that you are ready with your books and with the pencils as well, so that you can mark the hard words wherever you feel necessary. This chapter is all about flowers, students. Which flower depicts what? Like, you know, flowers are of different colors, rose, red, and many other colors are there. Okay, like which color depicts what? There are certain flowers which shows like deceit, fear, anger. Understood? There are flowers like that also. Understood? Each flower depicts something. So in this chapter we are going to study all about flowers. Interesting? Let's start. So many flowers do they serve to console one, she remarked vaguely. Somewhat at least, and from strangers, yet people are so kind. Okay, this chapter is about, you know, the backdrop of this chapter is Enola Holmes is a famous detective. First line from your book, Sherlock Holmes' sister and a daring detective in her own. So Enola Holmes is a detective. Detective, you know, jasus. Okay? And she is the sister, Sherlock Holmes' sister and a daring detective in her own. And who is Enola Holmes? She is the sister of Sherlock Holmes. Okay, and Sherlock Holmes has been a world famous detective. Clear? Dr. Watson, Sherlock Holmes' friend, has been missing for 3 days. And in this extract, Enola is visiting Mr. Watson and Mrs. Watson, who is very upset. So Mr. Watson is the husband of Mrs. Watson. So Mr. Watson jo hai, wo lapata hai bahut din se. He is like missing. Okay, and Enola visits Watson ke ghar mein aati hai, and she brings a bouquet of flower, and uski biwi Mrs. Watson, she is very tensed. Understood? So this person, Enola Holmes, she comes and visits Mrs. Watson and sees that Mrs. Watson is very, very like tensed and worried. Why? Because her husband was missing for 3 days. Clear? And Enola Holmes, she comes with a huge bouquet of flowers. Now see what happens. So many flowers do serve to console one. Understood? And yet comes from a stranger. Yet people are so kind. There was, of course, the bouquet I had bought. 3 was a little nosegay of little of the lily of the valley. Wishing Mrs. Watson the return of happiness, there were the ubiquitous carnations, some white roses, and the tucked away from the cake. Now what happened was that, listen. Enola Holmes come with the bouquet. Welcome, Mrs. Watson. How are you? Mrs. Watson was very tense because her husband was missing. Okay, what she did was that she laughed and she said that it's very strange that some strange people, stranger, comes to you and gives you a bouquet. She was very angry. She takes the bouquet from Enola and throws it in the corner table. Understood? Because she was fed up. Why? Because her husband was missing. Okay. And what was there out there in that bouquet? Bouquet mein kya kya tha? You can see there was 3 little nosegay. Nosegay are small little flowers. Okay. Underline the flowers which you will go through. Nosegay is one flower. Lily. It is also known as of the lily of the valley. Okay. Now what happened? And tucked away on a corner table the most bizarre bouquet. And she was not happy with that bouquet because that bouquet was very strange. Aisa bouquet tha jo kabhi dekha hi nahi tha. Different flowers the. And all the flowers was looking very dull kind of. Okay. So she was very angry and she did take that bouquet and threw it. I am sure I am a straightener. And my eyes widened, but I kept myself from saying anything from a murmured. How peculiar. Her eyes, Enola Watson's eyes bada bada ho gaya. Are, what she did? She threw the bouquet. How strange. But what happened? Enola Watson understands that wo thodi tension mein hai. Her husband is missing. Okay. So usne chillaya nahi, kuch nahi bola. She said that how peculiar. How strange. Peculiar means strange. Okay. What? Slowly Mrs. Watson turned to see had caught up my attention. Oh yes, odd, isn't it? The poppies should be red, but they are white, and they should be white, and they may should be white, but it's red, and I have no idea what the greens are. So she is looking at the flowers like a pagal ho gayi thi. Kaun? Mrs. Watson, because her husband was missing. Okay, she is looking at the table and she is saying that poppies ko yellow hona chahiye tha, but wo red hai. Jisko red hona chahiye tha, wo white hai. Kitna strange bouquet. So she is saying these things. Okay, she was very, very upset. Okay, you can understand. Asparagus, I marveled. Asparagus, underline another flower. Okay, so keep on underlining flowers. First was nosegay, then you can see here in the second, in the third paragraph, you can see poppies is one flower. Then May, M-A-Y, May is also a flower. It should be red, but wo white mein tha. Asparagus is also a flower. Okay, I marveled, not the vegetable of course, but the cobwebby fronds that spring up afterwards with leaves like sparse green gray hair. Once it is grown, you know. Mrs. Watson blinked, my goodness, how clever you are. How did you learn that? So, my mother was a botanist. Who says this? Now, see what happened was that Mrs. Watson was looking at the flowers and saying that how flowers are this? I don't like these things. Okay, asparagus bhi hai isme. Then she says that, yes, asparagus is also there. Then Mrs. Watson said that, aapko pata asparagus kya hai? Then he says that, yes, I know. How do you know? Mrs. Watson asks Enola. Enola says that my mother was a botanist. You know what is a botanist? Botanist means who studies about plants. Okay, different kind of plants. And she studied asparagus. Mrs. Watson is asking to Enola. Aur usne asparagus ke baare mein padhai kya? I never seen it placed in a bouquet before. Asparagus to kabhi bouquet mein hota hi nahi. I never see it before. Neither have I. But the greens were bizarre. Bizarre means strange. Underline. The blossoms were worse, their significance chilled me. Taking care not to reveal this in my tone of voice, I asked, Mrs. Watson, are you familiar with what is sometimes called the language of flowers? So, Mrs. Watson was behaving very strange. So, Enola asked that, do you know, Mrs. Watson, what is the language of flowers? Flowers ki ahemiyat kya hai? Do you understand this? Only a little, there has been small occasion for such my communication in life. She said this with a gentle good humor. The May signifies hope, does it not? And the poppy comfort. So May signifies hope. May se asha jagti hai. May ke flower se. Aur poppy comfort dikhata hai. In the French tradition, yes, but it was England and its British folklore. Hawthorn was a shrub. Underline again, hawthorn. Hawthorn again ek flower hai. It is a shrub. What do you say shrub? Small kind of a jhad, understood? Was a shrub long associated with pagan deities and fairies. So hawthorn, pagan deities, purane devta, understood? And fairies ke saath dikhaya jate hain. A powerful symbol of bad luck. Hawthorn nahi hona chahiye. Hawthorn, it is a kind of a kata, understood? Which you know, ye hona is a bad luck sign hai, theek hai? No countrywoman would ever bring a sprig of its pretty cluster blossoms indoors for due to some might bring down calamity even upon the house after death. Okay, so nobody brings this hawthorn ghar mein lana can bring a calamity also. Now you can see, you know, every flower shows different kind of a thing. May alag hai, poppy comfort deta hai, underline yaad karte jaoge, theek hai? And hawthorn brings bad luck in the house, theek hai? I did say the red poppies implies comfort, I believe, but the white poppy symbolizes sleep. Red poppy fir se. Red poppy kya dikhata, underline karo, implies comfort. Shanti, aaram, theek hai? Red poppy ghar mein aana matlab aapke ghar mein aaram aayega. You will have comfort in your home. Okay? And that white poppy symbolizes sleep. If you have white poppy in your home, that means it shows sleep. You will feel sleepy. Clear? Really, she thought about that moment that actually smiled. Well, I certainly could use some more sleep. Then she says that, okay, you have got white poppy, very good. Now I can sleep for some time. The poppies must have been forced in a hot house, but that have been asparagus has been so cultivated, most peculiar. Who on earth would trouble with such a useless prickle brush as hawthorn in a hot house, when, like a weed, it grew everywhere in the countryside? Upon studying the hawthorn more closely, I saw that jagged branches were wound round with tendrils of a delicate vine whose white flowers had already wilted. Bindweed. See, there was another flower underlined, bindweed. Okay. Just you have to underline in this chapter that consa flower symbolizes what. That only you have to understand. Okay. And all this activity kaha pe place ho raha tha? In the Watson's house. Who had brought the flowers? Enola Holmes. Who was Enola Holmes? The sister of Sherlock Holmes. Okay, that is a famous detective. Theek hai? Who was missing? Mr. Watson was missing. For how many days? For 3 days. Theek hai? A sort of wild trumpet flower bindweed would be as common as sparrows in the country hedge growers from summertime. But like hawthorn, this flower in the country forced indoors. More, it has been cultivated in the hawthorn into entwined. Bindweed, more correctly uses convolvulus. Convolvulus, the plant indicated something convoluted, something steely, entangling and twisted. This ominous bouquet, it seemed to me, had come from quite a twisted mind that I had found. Okay, so this chapter is all about your flowers, which flower symbolizes what and all those things. Okay, so Bindweb is all about. So once again I'm repeating, what you have to understand in this chapter, which flower signifies what, that will understand in the question as well also. Now we'll do the question answers of this chapter. I hope you can just give a brief reading for this chapter if you can go through. Thank you very much. Okay, here we are back with the question answers. Option first is A1 option will be A, second one option will be again A, third one option will be B, fourth one will be C, and fifth one will be C. Now B, out here you can see that the bouquet is given here, so you can mark it. See how you will do is that the first one is bindweed. Okay, bindweed, I guess you can see it is visible, bindweed, bindweed, bindweed. This one is May, May, May. Okay, this red one is also May, May, May. And fourth one is poppy, poppy. Okay, bindweed, May, May, poppy. Okay, next, number two, why has Mrs. Watson received the flowers? Mrs. Watson received the flowers as a sign of consolation. Consolation means shanti, ya fir samjhota ke liye, shantana jaise kehte hain. Okay, for that, because her husband Mr. Watson had been missing for 3 days, and however she received a peculiar bouquet as a sign of a veil threat. It was a threat, no? It's like somebody is missing and somebody comes to your home and gives you a bouquet. What does it mean? It is a threat, ek chetavni hai, pe dar hai. Why? Might be the person is dead. Okay, so that they are getting a bouquet. So it is a veiled threat. Veiled means hided, hidden threat. Okay, number three, what is the difference between nosegay and bouquet? Nosegay is a small bunch of trimmed flowers, small bunch of trimmed, kate hue upar se trimmed flowers, whereas a bouquet is a large bunch of untrimmed flowers. Untrimmed means not cut, okay, not designed, like this is a bouquet. Clear? Next, question number four, what are the greens, what was the peculiar about them? The greens in the bouquet was asparagus. The peculiar thing about the asparagus was that they were cultivated with a lot of a trouble for the bouquet, while they were found in abundance in countryside. Countryside means village. Okay, next, number five, how did Enola know the strange item in the bouquet was asparagus? The strange item was asparagus because her mother was a botanist. Botanist, I told you, anyone who studies about plants. And because she had seen this item in a bouquet before, and Enola had seen this item before also. Number six, identify the last paragraphs. So the words are still the convoluted, ominous and twisted. Okay, these handwritten notes are also there in the school website. You can copy it from there also as well, where you can get in a handwritten form. Okay, so now you can pause the video and write it. Yes students, we are back with the question answers that we have discussed previously. So answers in detail, page number 19, answers are here. The first answer, what was the grown with hawthorn and what was it peculiar? Bindweed was grown with hawthorn. Peculiarly like the hawthorn, the bindweed was also forced to grow indoors along with the hawthorn. Moreover, the plant indicated something convoluted and twisted and thus wasn't a good sign. Clear? So next question says, where did Enola think the flowers had been grown and what were they grown there? Enola believed that the flowers were grown indoors forcefully. She thought so because these plants were mostly found in the countryside and because it was too early in the year for them to grow naturally. Now the last answer is, third one says, their significance chilled me. Okay, so what was the emotion on the experience? What was the significance that it told? Okay, so this is the third question which it says. Okay, so the answer is quite this way. The lines show Enola to experience fear and uncertainty. The blossom signified sinister things like deep sleep and death, and these feelings were considered to bring bad luck. Enola was chilled because she believed that the bouquet was veiled threat and predicted unpleasant things to come. Rest of the short questions are being duly provided in the PDF. I hope and believe that you will go there, download the PDF and write it as per your feasibility. Okay, so till then, we come to this end of this chapter. Okay, you'll copy all the notes properly in your copy freshly, and then we are coming with the next chapter in your literature reader, that is a small book. Get ready with that. Thank you.